Hey guys, it's a privilege to present to you an interview that we conducted with Mr. Jake Fussell back in January. And here is Mr. Jake Fussell telling us a little bit about himself.
Well, I started at Fidelis in 2011 as a freshman, went all 4 years and graduated in 2014, or I guess it was 2010 when I started, but graduated in 2014, went to LaGrange College initially to play baseball and studied chemistry there. And then finished my Bachelor of Science in Chemistry in 2018, where I then moved to Tucson, Arizona to begin my PhD studies in chemistry at the University of Arizona, which is where I currently am.
Awesome.
Do you have any advice in general that you would like to give our Fidelis students?
I think just, you know, enjoy where you're at. I know Fidelis can kind of be a not a high pressure environment, but the expectations are pretty high, you know, from what I remember with teachers, and that's not a bad thing at all. But don't put so much pressure on yourself that you stop enjoying where you are. You know, make sure to take the time to look around and appreciate your classmates that are willing to study with you, appreciate the teachers that are willing to answer questions, and really work on investing in those relationships because they do help you out in the long run.
In your opinion, like in high school and both college and high school, have you had any like big mistakes that you've have helped you learn and grow at all? Like any that stand out?
I don't know about any like major mistakes, but there's definitely lessons you learn along the way. And I think one of the best pieces of advice I got from a professor in college was, if you wait to do something until you have a big block of time, like an hour to do it, you'll never get anything done. So even if you can only, you know, work on your math homework for 5 minutes, work on it for 5 minutes. And that's a more productive use of your time than saying, oh, well, I don't have an hour to work on this homework, so I'm just not going to do it.
Speaking about like time management, you played as a pitcher at LaGrange, correct?
Yes.
So was it like tough to balance sports and academics in your first 2 years of college?
Oh, definitely. There's a lot of, even playing sports in high school too, there's a lot of missed classes for games and having to do homework on a bus and having to, you know, pull late nights on a road trip and stuff like that. But again, that kind of comes down to don't procrastinate on things, work ahead where you can, and you know, keep the main thing the main thing. The main thing is always your school, whether you're playing sports or not. And sports are important, but, you know, keep school at the front and then schedule everything else around that.
So since you've been to both private and public university, do you prefer one over the other, or have you noticed any differences between the two?
So I don't know if that I'll compare and contrast private versus public, but I can definitely compare like a large university versus a small school. So at LaGrange, our entire campus was maybe around like 1,200 people at the most. So not very many people there. Personally, I preferred that, especially coming from a small high school like Fidelis, because it allowed me to really get to know the professors and really get to know the people around me. And that becomes a lot more valuable later. For example, I had really good professors as friends in other departments, not just the chemistry department that I knew. And because it was a small school, they knew me really well. And so when it came time to like, oh, I need this class they're teaching, can you let me in even though it's full? They're like, oh yeah, I know you, so I'll let you in. And that kind of thing is never gonna happen at a big university.
So what do you do in your leisure time as a PhD student in Arizona?
Arizona is a fantastic place to live. It is like 7-8 months a year, it's 75 degrees and sunny. So we have no trouble getting outside and going on hikes. And in Southern Arizona, the cool thing about Tucson is it's surrounded by 4 mountain ranges. And so there's a lot of great hiking to do around. There's some cool parks, lots of cool attractions. But I also play on in a men's senior baseball league here. So do that on the weekends. But yeah, lots of cool hiking and outdoor stuff to do, which is fine with me because I like doing it.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Have you had any internships or job opportunities with your college and major so far?
Yeah, so in college, in order to kind of boost your resume for graduate school, you need to be looking for these kinds of opportunities. And so one nice thing that exists in the sciences are something called REUs, so REU, and they are funded by the National Science Foundation and exist at larger universities primarily to give students from smaller universities opportunities to do research. And so after my sophomore year, I participated in one of these programs at Georgia Southern University and got paid to do research for 10 weeks on their campus. So those are definitely opportunities that exist and are really good for college students to look into. And then the next year, I took an internship at a company in Alpharetta that made plastic coatings. So that was another like research-based internship. So yeah, those opportunities are definitely out there and they're looking for people. And the nice thing about the sciences is that these internships often pay very well because they need people to do the work. So that's something you can definitely look into for like a summer job.
So this is a pretty standard interview question, but where do you see yourself in 5 years?
So the goal right now is in probably another 2.5 to 3 years is when I'll finish my degree, finish my PhD, and then enter to hopefully a pharmaceutical company, hopefully in the Southeast, like North Carolina, somewhere in there. But I would really like to be doing pharmaceutical research in some capacity in within 5 years. Guys, I appreciate you guys reaching out. I'm always happy to talk about what I do and give advice to the students. And you know, please don't hesitate for you guys or anyone watching this to contact me. And if you have any questions about careers and degrees in chemistry and in the sciences, feel free to put my contact info for my email if you want to. So anyone who needs to get in touch for those questions, I'm happy to answer them.
Well, thanks for doing this.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem, guys. I appreciate it.